Georgia.
Georgia. Hello, everyone. So, today is January 5th, 2020, and it marks 16 years since my mother, our mother, our grandmother, sister, daughter, all the grandparents are gone, but mom was still a daughter. It's been 16 years since she left us and went to heaven today. I thought to myself, what am I going to do? Am I just going to make another Facebook post to say, Mom, I love you and I miss you and throw it up? No, I want to do something a little more. I remembered I had some pictures. Pictures of the last Christmas and New Year's that we spent with Mom back in 2003 going into 2004. I was looking at some of these pictures this morning and I thought to myself, it's been 16 years now. And my Sonny Boys, Ben and Bradley, never had a chance to meet their grandmother. And my mom never had a chance to meet her grandsons. That hurts, you know. And on this day, 16 years later, especially looking at those pictures, it brings tears to my eyes. I think back to this new year and this Christmas that we got to spend with Mom. And we were very, very fortunate to have this time with her. We were very, very fortunate to know that God was getting ready to take her up with Him. Not a lot of families get that. A lot of families have their loved ones yanked from them with no warning whatsoever. And that's got to be a heartache. And it scares the shit out of me to think of any of my family or friends out there having to go through that. So we were very, very fortunate being able to spend this time with Mom. But this is what I want to do for all my family and my friends, any of my loved ones, especially if you had the opportunity to be touched by my mom. She touched a lot of people. My mom would take the shirt off her back in a heartbeat for anybody. She was 48 years old when she died. 48. That's 5 years older than what I am now. And I think about that. I think about what a great and awesome person she was. And the only lesson she ever tried to instill in us was to lead by example with love and caring and compassion. And I have fallen short of that, no doubt. I definitely have. But it being 2020 and it being a new year and looking at these pictures, it's reminded me that her legacy lives on through me, through my sisters, through my sons. Ben and Bradley, you never had a chance to meet your grandmother, but her spirit, her warrior spirit, her loving spirit, it lives through you. So I hope you went to school today, you held your head up high. I hope my whole family is holding their head up high, knowing that you had a mother, a sister, a wife, everything she was to everybody, she gave it 110% to be there for us. So I'm going to sit down and I'm going to get these pictures into a video for everybody to view. And I want to preface this. My mother was a beautiful woman. Okay? These photos were taken just a couple of weeks before she went. She had been fighting ovarian and cervical cancer with everything she had at this point. And you'll see these photos, They don't show a great looking mom, a great looking Jody. They show a mom and a Jody that had been battling for her life. This was the hardest time of my life ever. Spending this Christmas and New Year's with my mother and my family. We all knew what was going to happen. So for all of my sisters who sat there and opened up gifts with our mother, this is for you. I know I don't have to say it to tell you guys to never forget. I know the four of us will never forget. But I hope this brings back some loving memories somehow. And the fact that all four of my mother's kids, we're all warriors. We have that warrior blood. Ben and Bradley, you have that warrior blood in you. Look at these pictures. Look what this woman was going through. She's a warrior, and that blood runs through your veins. I love you guys. I love everybody out there watching this. I'm going to get busy right now, and I'm going to get this put together. I don't even know how many photos, maybe 40 photos. But I'm going to put some music to it. I'm going to do what I do. I hope you guys enjoy it. Mom, I miss you. I know you look down on us. I got dragonflies everywhere. Please continue to visit your grandsons. To everybody out there, have an awesome new year. This whole decade of the 20s is going to roar for us. I love you all. Let's get to this movie. Hey guys, so just want to let you know, these photos are in the order in which I took them. So essentially chronological order of Christmas Day, and then you'll see where I'll get with these photos. Stay tuned. I hope you find something to bring you some enjoyment. So, we're moving into New Year's Eve now, and let me preface this by saying, Kathy, you had already had went back to California at this point, so you weren't here for this night. So I'm glad you get to see some of these pictures. I know that you have probably seen them at this point years ago, but it was a cold night. We lit fireworks, and I'll never forget spending this last night. This last New Year's Eve with my mom, your grandmother, boys. It was very, very precious to be able to spend this time with her. It was cold that night, and she sat out there on that porch swing, and she watched us light fireworks. It was amazing. It was amazing. Everything about this picture is hard on me when I look at it. This was the very last time I sat next to your grandmother, my mom. The very last picture I ever got with her. This was January 1st, 2004. I had to leave that New Year's Day. So that New Year's Eve, that night, launching fireworks off with mom, your grandmother sitting on the swing, watching, just staying involved. She was so sick that night, and it was so hard on her. But she was there. She was there. She made sure that she spent her last moments with her kids. So, yeah, this is a difficult picture for me to look at. I'm so very thankful I have it. I'm so very thankful God blessed me with the mother that He did. Now, I flew home, and I was in California for all of 5 days when I got that phone call. I'll never forget that phone call. Boys, I was laying next to your mom, and I got the phone call from my stepdad, Tim, that my mother had passed away that morning. So, the next pictures you're about to view is when Kathy and I flew back to Florida, and mom was cremated. My grandmother and my Aunt Mary and my Aunt Chris were there, and my mama loved roses, so they bought her a nice... They bought her some barrels with roses. You'll see those in the photos here. And then we cremated mom, and mom loved Sanibel Island, so we took her remains out. Some friends of hers had a boat we went on, and we scattered her ashes. And I'll pick up the story when we get to the part where we ran ashore with the sand dollars.
Georgia, the whole day through, just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind.
This wreath, this is the wreath that we placed in the water to float mom's ashes out to sea. Here's Tim getting ready to push mom's ashes out to sea. Miss you, mom. And there she goes. I love you, mom. It was beautiful watching you drift away in a beautiful spot that you loved. Here Aunt Chris is singing a song, and forgive me, Aunt Chris, I forget the name of that song you sang, but I remember it being beautiful, and I remember it being heartfelt from one sister to another. I know it was hard for you, but you did an awesome job. I love you, Aunt Chris. Look at all the tears in her eyes. It was a very sad morning, but I know we all felt a peace for mom, knowing that she wasn't in any more pain. What a beautiful morning. I would never ask for it any other way. I feel so bad because I have forgotten their name, but these are mom and Tim's friends who took us out on their boat that morning and was part of us sending mom off. Thank you, guys. So these are just random pictures of that morning. I want you to be able to relive what kind of morning that was. We got out there before sunset, of course. So so you'll see the sun come up. It was a cloudy, overcast morning for sure. Like I said, it was a bit on the chilly side. So we're trying to steam back right now, trying to get back to where we launched the boat. And so we're just cruising along, and in good fashion, Mom was with us like she always was and always is. And you'll see what I'm talking about here in a moment. Only in a way Mom could do it. She made sure that we knew she was with us that morning. It was a beautiful sunrise for sure. So we scattered Mom off the island of Sanibel there in Florida. And Sanibel / Captiva. We pushed her ashes off by the lighthouse. There's a point there with the lighthouse on it. And as you can see, in fashion that only Mom could do, we got stuck on a sandbar trying to get back to the boat dock. And that's Tim walking around on the sandbar. And guess what we found on the sandbar? That's right, Mom's favorite sand dollars. There were thousands and thousands of sand dollars everywhere. I really hope this brought back some memories for everybody. I love you, Mom. It's been 16 years. Ben and Bradley, I wish you could have met your grandmother. But please watch this video and know that if she was here, she would swoop you guys up and love you to death. I love you, Mom. I love everybody. I hope you guys found some peace in this video. Have a happy new year.